Konnichiwa, and welcome to my Japanese cultural booth. Konnichiwa means welcome. So welcome. Come on over. I want to show you how to make some sushi today. Here we go. Let's get started. So over here I have laid out every single thing we're going to need to make some sushi. So we have all of our vegetables that we're going to use. We have the proper knives. We have chopsticks, soy sauce, rice, water, a towel that's moistened, and some vegetables that are going to be used for chopping. So just for chopping demonstration purposes. So what I want to do is show you real quick the proper way to chop vegetables to make sushi. So here we go. You're going to take a whole cucumber and you're going to cut it down the center and remove the skin. Here's some cucumber that I already have cut up. And what you want to do is you want to make sure that your slices are very thin, just like these are. But here we go. So we cut it in half and then we're going to cut it lengthwise. Very slender slices. You want to make sure that you're very careful with the knife, that you don't cut towards yourself, that you cut away from yourself, and you're always watching your fingers at all times. So you're going to use this same technique to cut your carrots and your avocado and your cucumbers and your cream cheese. Okay, so that's how we do that for the veggies. We're going to send it back over here. Put the knife over there. So here we go. This is the seaweed and it's called nori. And nori has two sides to it. One is kind of dull and the other one is super shiny. So I'm sure you can see that's pretty shiny. This is a sushi mat. So we're going to put the shiny side down onto the mat. And what we're going to do is we're going to wet our fingers with water and we're going to shake them off just like this. Then we're going to take the rice. We're going to put the rice with our fingers all the way across the mat. And you want to spread it out to the edges. All the way, all the way, all the way. And you want to continue to do this until you hit about 1 inch away from the edge of the nori. I'm going to put my hands in the water again because they're getting a little sticky. And then I don't want to dry them all the way off. I would just want to dry them a little bit so they are able to not stick to the rice. Now I'm going to take my avocado and put it across lengthwise across the rice, and some carrot and some cream cheese and the cucumber. Looks pretty yummy. So now what I'm gonna do is take my sushi mat. I'm gonna take the edge of it, bring it over the vegetables, and tuck it in. Okay, tuck, and as you're tucking in, you're also pulling a little tighter, and a little tighter, all the way across. Then you lift the mat up, and you continue to roll. And you roll it over and roll and roll, and you're using pressure. And then that's it. That is your sushi roll. So you take this and you put it over to the side and you take your knife. Remember that you need a moist towel to make sure that your your knife is wet in between each slice. So you slice all the way down. Let me move my hand. Slice all the way down. Apply a little bit of pressure. Wipe your knife off again. And you continue this until you're done going all the way across the sushi, the length of the sushi. So this is what the inside looks like. Looks pretty good, huh? So you're gonna slice it all the way across, all the way across, all the way across, until you're done. Then what you wanna do is you wanna get a little bowl and you put a little bit of soy sauce, a little bit of wasabi. You're going to use some chopsticks and you're going to pick up your sushi with your chopsticks, dip it in your soy mixture and eat it. So a couple things real quick before I let you go. Japanese culture and some other Asian cultures also use chopsticks to eat with. And some of them are ceremonial, some of them are disposable. These actually happen to be ceremonial. But how to use them is you kind of hold it like you would a pencil. You put the one on the very top across your index finger and your middle finger, and the one on the bottom rests on your ring finger. And your thumb lies across both of them. So the first one, the top one, is the one that really manipulates everything around, and the bottom one is really what squeezes and holds it. So there you have it, sushi. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Come by again if you'd like. Tell your friends. Alrighty, bye bye.